Hi, this is Topher with Winning WP. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Gravity Forms to build a contact form for your WordPress site. Gravity Forms is the largest commercial forms plugin for WordPress. There is no free version, which means in order to get it, you have to come here to gravityforms.com and pay $59 to get it. I've already done that, so let's skip ahead to installing the plugin and building a form. We'll go to Plugins. Add new. Now, because it's not a free plugin, I'm not going to search up here. I'm going to click Upload Plugin. Here's my zip file, and I will install now. And then we activate the plugin. Now, because it's a commercial plugin, we need to register our copy. I'm going to put my key in here, and then we'll skip ahead to the part we're actually making a form. Now that installation is complete, there's a button here to create a form. The first thing it wants is a form title and description. The title is required, but the description is not. And now we're on the form building page, which has some pretty great instructions. The first thing is to select a field type. We'd want a name on our contact form. So over here on the right are a whole bunch of standard HTML fields, but under advanced, there's a name field. So I'm going to drag this name button over here. And by default, it asks for first name and last name. Optionally, we can open up some permissions here, and we can choose. Now it's just first. But you can have middle and suffix and all of that. We can go to advanced and put in all sorts of additional options. I'm going to leave it at first and last. Now we also want an email address. We'll drag that right over. And you may have noticed that I can drag these around to reorder them if I wish. Now we have an email field. Let's throw in a phone field as well. And then lastly, some place to put in just some plain text. Now this one, because it's not advanced, is untitled. So we need to go in here and put in some text. Now, right now, none of these is required. I'm going to make email required by clicking this box. And I'm going to make message required clicking this box. That way, if they want to remain kind of anonymous and not give me their phone number, but still send a message, they can. So now we have a form with name, email, phone, and message. Let's click Update. Now our form exists, but we need to decide what happens when someone fills it out. So under Settings, let's go to Confirmations. And right now, there's a text confirmation that goes to the person who filled out the form. We'll click Edit. It simply says, "Thanks for contacting us. We will get in touch with you shortly." We'll leave that the way it is. Then notifications. Admin notification. This is for letting you know that someone filled out your form. So we want to send to an email address. And right now it's set to admin email. So it's whoever owns this website. But you can type in any email address here and it will work. And then from, we can choose from the form fields. Name first, name last. We'll put a space between them. And then the from email, we'll leave this as the admin email, but we're going to set up reply to as the one that the person filled in. so that when you hit reply to their message, it sends right back to them. Oh, come on. You can optionally blind carbon copy. We're going to leave that empty. Then we have the subject line. Now keep in mind, this email is going to you because somebody filled out your form. New message from form title. You could put in your website name. You could put anything in here you want, as long as you know where the form came from. And then the message has the tag simply all fields. If you want, you could put in individual fields one at a time and order them very carefully. But all fields usually works just to get you all the information. We're not going to mess with auto formatting or conditional logic. We'll just click update notification. Now there's one last setting area here called personal data. This is for managing the data that people give you. These options allow you to be GDPR compliant. The GDPR is a law in Europe regarding storing personal data. So read over these options and see if any of them apply to your organization. Now our form is complete, but it's not on a web page yet. Let's make that happen. We'll go to Pages, Add New. Type Contact Us. To choose our Gutenberg block for our form, we click Add Block. And then it could be any number of places under this menu. But fortunately, here at the top, we can search. And simply click Gravity Forms. We select a form and click Contact Us. And there's our form in the editor. We can choose whether or not to print the title and description. We didn't have a description, so you don't see one. But I'm going to turn off title, and you'll see that Contact Us disappears. Now I'll click Publish. And let's view this page. Here's our website with a contact form right on it. I'll fill it out. And submit. And there it says, thanks for contacting us. We will get in touch with you shortly. And that's all there is to it, to making a contact form with Gravity Forms for WordPress. If you'd like even more great content, check out winningwp.com and also subscribe to this YouTube channel.